In do part two of this LFR. Okay, recruitment. Okay, this is the next thing for recruiting for guilds. So, you're in a guild, you're a guild leader, you're a recruitment officer, God help you. You want to find people for your guild. Recruitment is the hardest friggin' thing to do in a guild. Well, one of the hardest things to do. First hardest thing is obviously, you know, doing my job. But recruitment sucks. It has always sucked. Unless you love it and you have a passion for really recruiting, you may always hate recruitment. So there's different types of recruitment, different levels of recruitment based on effort and effectiveness. The first one and the most easiest thing is make a recruitment post on the guild forum. So the 11 out of 14 guy, I think he was 11 out of 14. Make sure you have a guild recruitment post up. Here is ours. Right here. Here, I'll link it in chat as well. That is our recruitment post, and you know what to put on it. So here, you know what we're looking for, your current progression. So we got US 59th in Siege of Orgrimmar. I think we could have done better. I think we could have done a lot better. Sure, it was better than our last couple tiers, but still, I mean, I would have liked more. I would have liked top 50 US minimum. In your recruitment post, you would type in, you know, when you raid. We never raid on Fridays and Sundays. Friday to Sundays. What classes we're recruiting. And information about us. So here's, you know, we're always recruiting for exceptional applicants of any class. When we were formed, January 27th, 2005. So we're now 9 years old. One of the oldest and one of the most respected raiding guilds on Stormreach. Because we're known as, you know, good classy people as well as, you know, pretty good raiders. What we offer you, what we want from players, what we would expect. Here's a link to our recruitment information, our recruitment page, and here's contact information. So officer, I need to add brand to this. Here's my battle tag or my real ID, and then our email if you ever have questions. That is one thing you do, super easy. Well, the initial investment is quite a bit of time, and then you can always tweak it, adjust it as you need to, and all you do is just bump it. Bump. But you see, like, Lottie, Hipster, guys that don't play anymore, they just bump these. They bump the threads. You're not supposed to bump threads, but Blizzard would be dumb. And you just bump threads. You can just keep it bumped at the top of the page. Because guild recruitment things, they fly. I mean, it constantly flies. Here, I'm going to add a post. Coach's Corner. There. Coach's Corner. I made a post. And now it will go to the top of the page in a couple seconds here. So more people can see it. The more you bump it, the more exposure you get, the more you'll get apps. That's what it comes down to. More and more and more. That's level one recruitment. Super, super easy to do. Let me put somebody on follow. Who do I trust? Who do I trust in this group? Midgets. Of course I trust midgets. Kind of silly question is that. I'm coming, guys. I'm coming. As they clear trash. I'm coming. How many raid leaders should you have for a 25 man? As many as you need. You can have one, you can have two, you can have five with delegated responsibilities. It depends. It depends on what works for your guild. There is no perfect answer. You have to find what works for you. That's it. You know, we have myself, Driez, and then to a lesser extent we have, well, to the same extent, we have Bran as well, which does a lot of the spreadsheet work for us. I've already used my speed boost. Does a lot of the cooldown stuff. We have Schomburg as well, that's been helping out as well, and we have other people that do help out with strats and things like that, but there's no one easy answer. You know, I wish that every member in my raid team was a raid leader. Why? Because they would be really good players then. They would be very, very good players and super aware players. Okay, let me do this boss here and then I'll go back to recruitment. I'm not sure if we changed the sub password. Spread out, go soak stuff. But anytime you guys have questions about what add-ons I'm running or what add-on is talking to me, that's called VEM. What circle little thing here for Malakrok I'm using, that's called Malakrok Helper, or VEM also does it. But everybody's here. Dead man, whenever you're ready, go ahead and pull. We have 15 raiders. Okay, Trump, ask me that question about 10 minutes. I'll answer it. That's a good one. And I have answered it before. Or DGP. Yeah, DGP, you're tank two. I really like this location.
Straight into the circles.
Circles, circles. So right now, I know we've taken a second of recruitment. This, right here I have a range radar, which is what I need, because I never want to be too close to people. Right here, I'm standing on Critique. He's too close to Jalissa. Too close. Guess my Malachar caliper isn't that working. I'm guessing he was not sent over here. Why? Well, because that little knock in the air hits people within 5 yards. So if I was standing on somebody else there, like I was standing on the hunter, then it would have hit us both in the air. And that's extra damage, that's unnecessary. Toasty, nice DPS. He's toasty. Oh. I guess right, good. Yeah, I don't like the VEM sort of add-on. It doesn't work too well. Don't like it at all. I can smash here.
Straight into the circles.
That's the thing. A lot of really good raid leaders know what to expect of members shuttle. And yeah, that's one of the great things that make your guild good. Because everybody has been a raid leader in that position before. They don't want to let their friends down. They know what it's like to be let down by their members for whatever fucking reason. And they have high expectations of themselves and their other players. So having a guild full of raid leaders, that's fucking amazing. Also, I'm not using Selfless Healer Shuttle. Totally not it. My healing is still shit.
Spread into the circles.
Soak Z Paddles. Good job. Good job.
Breath incoming. 3, 2, 1.
Don't get hit. Oh, this is where you got hit. Stacking on the tank here. Use VM, DBM, no, you only run one, Dr. Hubs. Only one or the other. Do not run both. Basically the same add-on. VEM will talk to you, though. See, that's VEM right there. It says Eldandra's far enough now, I can dispel him, and I did dispel him.
Spread.
And I'm probably just gonna go boss. Cool. Let's move on. Okay, so next thing for recruitment. Having a WoW progress page that is updated frequently, let me load up mine here for you guys, that is really beneficial. We have, you know, a number of different resources. We track how we get apps, you know, whether it be word of mouth, or a Sparty stream, or WoW progress, or the guild recruitment forums. Those are the four main ways we get recruits right now. So let me put Mages unfollow. Where is she? Over here. There, we got her. Thanks, Midgets. So here is our WoW progress page. Tells you your rank, whatever, whatever. What you're recruiting. So when I show you guys how to find a guild, this is great for it. So right now we're recruiting, you know, Death Knight, DKs that are direct damage, Balance and Feral damage, Hunter. I should probably put that as not recruiting hunters. Monks, a Windwalker hunt, monk probably, any kind of rogue, medium, enhancement shaman is what we're looking for as well. I have high need for one of those. Warlocks, always high, this never goes high, or never low. And then warriors, direct damage. So this is the same post, or similar post, that I made on the recruitment forums. Basically, I update it. And when people search for a guild, they see me, you know, on Stormrage, we're looking for these classes, and here's information about us. You should have a nice big post, enough to read. And again, leaving that contact information right there is pretty crucial. Really, really crucial. Yeah, sorry, walls bad. So, WoW progress, keep it updated. It takes very little work to keep it updated. I gotcha. Very little work to keep it updated. And, yeah, and people search through it. So that's level 1 recruitment. Least amount of work, not as effective as the other kinds. You can keep a WoW progress and a guild recruitment thread. They're absolutely crucial. I mean, you need to have those because it's so little effort and it does give you a decent amount of hits. Now, the next thing... Why does it keep losing me? I don't know why. Sparty, I'm a mage from the dude who wears my mount. I don't know if you know them. I don't know. We are at the moment on Siegecrafter Heroic. We're playing Frost, which isn't the best spec. When I play Fire, people ask my raid why I only do 200k, and with Frost I'm doing 300,000. But they keep saying that I must play Fire because I do more DPS. But I can't seem to understand Fire. Any tips or videos? Talk to other mages. Go to Icy Veins. Go to Icy Veins and look at the Fire rotation there. It's tracking your procs is the biggest thing. Tracking your scorches, your pyros, your combustion, that kind of stuff. But Icy Veins is a great starting thing for Fire. At that point, you sort of should know how to play Fire if you're already in a heroic Siegecrafter. But if you're having issues or tips, talk to other mages that are better than you. Talk to someone like... He's not online. Hensington. Hensington loves to talk about mage stuff. Or talk to other mages that are better than you and see what they're doing differently. You know, see, watch a YouTube video from a mage perspective. Type in heroic Siegecrafter Fire Mage POV. That's it. And you can see their spell rotation. You can see what add-ons they're using. Then you can talk to them. You know, or if you know how to go through logs, look at which ones are doing really well. And then talk to those guys as well. Easy to hunt them down. Does Gavin stream or YouTube? He does have a YouTube, yes. He has a ton of YouTube. It doesn't show Fire as top DPS, really? What resources do you use, Austin? Which ones? And why, I mean, you would definitely use Fire on Heroic Siegecrafter. You would never use Arcane. Fire's inconsistent. Yeah, it's a lot RNG. You know, whatever crit you get lucky with. Sometimes I see a huge disparity between my mages because lucky crits, lucky openers, blah, 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 blah. Let's talk about Ariana, but time to think of UK things. Yeah, exactly. Talk to people that are, you know, are really good and, you know, they'll help you out. Please talk to Hensington about it so he doesn't talk to us about it. Guys, if you're a mage, you are going to do me a huge favor by talking to Hensington so he doesn't talk to me. Because every time I log on my Ventrilo, he's talking. He's talking about something. Sometimes he's the only guy on vent, and his Ventrilo is talking. Like, really?
What?
Hensington.
What?
Sometimes he's the only person on the Ventrilo, and he's talking to himself about mages. Yeah, like, I shit you not. Please talk to Hens if you're a mage. Sorry? Because he doesn't notice that nobody's listening. He's a really good guy, though. He's a great mage. And he loves to talk. I mean, you love that passion about him. That's what I really like about Hensington. He's got a lot of passion. As shitty as his friggin' gnome warrior is, he's got a great mage. Just talk. Yeah, freezing. Thanks for a good rush.
Attack for the deer.
Yeah, I mean, you have to have enough fire or enough crit to go fire, which makes the crits really, really, well, a lot more consistent, but there's still a chance you might have, you know, really crappy luck, right? What was that, Hens? Blah, 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 every raid. Yeah, so that's that. But no, use those mage resources, the resources that I use to, you know, what is best DPS, show fire up there, and I can show you that. Hopefully I won't die here. Where is fire? So we have arcane highest. We have fire pretty high up there as well. Here, I'll show you really quick here. So these are the top DPS parses. Let's say Iron Juggernaut is a great DPS parsing fight. And let's look at how... Yeah, so this is, you know, top 100 parses in 25 man heroics. This is how the DPS are faring. I mean, nobody plays Arms Warriors. Don't run Arms. Arms Warriors, not so strong. So people that keep asking, don't run Arms. People also don't run Marksmanship. That is not a great spec. People generally don't run Demonology as well. I mean, it's okay on some fights, but there. So these are the specs that you typically see in a raid. Frost is being the lowest here with 383, but again, that's average damage on Iron Juggernaut. Fire, you see, where's fire? That's arcane, and fire damage is right around here. So it is middle of the pack. It can be a little bit higher or lower, depends on your crit and all that other stuff, but it is pretty high. The only thing why, or one of the reasons that arcane is so high on this fight is because you can move. The less movement there is, oh, they left me alone. The less movement there is as a mage, the more arcane will shine. If you just stand there and shoot your friggin' arcane balls everywhere, then you'll have a lot of DPS. Save it. Good job. Good job. Yeah, don't ever use Noxic. Noxic is toxic, exactly.
Rune of Power.
Simulation craft, Noxic, Icy Veins. Icy Veins all the way. Icy Veins is looked at by a number of heroic raiders, and they can vouch for the information on it. It does need to be updated. I know Shuttle was looking at updating the Paladin resources because it's old. It's a little outdated, but it's still one of the best resources out there in terms of great information. Icy Veins is awesome. Anyway, these are generally DPS numbers, you know, on that fight. You want to look at a fight like Siege. Well, it's not going to work for Siegecrafter because there are no parses for Siegecrafter. Because of how the logs are parsed. What's another high movement fight? Let's look at now Gallicrest. Shock Pride, maybe. Arcane Simple's Head, because those mages can just stand there and they'll be fine. But it depends. Depends on the fight. Totally depends on the fight. Let me close that down. Yeah, here. Vikina, that fire mage, he does have a bunch of guides as well. Sorry, I forgot that. Thank you, Zephyr, for mentioning that. Meta does have some guides on their website, I believe, and Vikina has his own thing. For Warlocks, they have something similar. They would have Sparkug's guide, right? Sparkug's the Warlock. He's awesome, and he likes to teach Warlocks how to play. Use his guides. Just have to look around for those resources, and there are plenty out there. Blue Paladin guide should be up to date. Did you get it updated, Shuttle? Is that the newest thing? You have it updated? Do we not kill everything? Why are people so slow? Come on, guys. Come on. There we go. Excellent. Okay. Stop shamelessly plugging yourself. He should be. Why not? Check him out on his channel, too. Numen, I'll have to answer your question afterwards. I can't, what? I'm a Windwalker monk. I have 520 item one item level. I can't do more LFRs this week. And people usually want 540, 540. Can you give advice on what to do? Cap out on Valor. So if you're doing all your LFRs, cap out on Valor, make sure you bought any Valor gear. So if you still have, you know, level 496 bracers weighing you down, buy 522 bracers from the Valor vendor in Town Long Steps. That's step one. Step two, make sure you are capping out on Valor and working on your Legendary Cloak. That will inflate your numbers of item level. Step three, if you've done all of that and you have nothing to spend Valor on, upgrade your gear. Spend that Valor on upgrading your gear to raise your item level. And then, I mean, you can always do heroic scenarios to get 516 item level. Make sure you have that Timeless Burden thing. But between that, you know, crafted gear, LFRs, make sure you're doing those celestial bosses for a chance at tier. Nox told you to do something, but I heal better when I drill on my keyboard. Any tips? My suggestion would be go to Noxic, make a video of this, and we might be able to, you know, improve Noxic's guides with your video of drooling. This would be an excellent plan for us. Great job. Great job. Read Noxic, do opposite. Pretty much that. Pretty much that. So let me cover recruitment, guys. I'll answer your questions, Nana Knight and everybody else. Give me just a few minutes. Let me cover recruitment first, and then I'll move on to some questions and things like that. I guess I can answer questions now while I'm sort of healing. Sort of. Nana Knight, I'm going to cover how to find a guild. You know, there's when you're transitioning from a casual guild to a heroic guild, a lot of our apps fail, and I mean, we're sort of hesitant to take apps that haven't had a lot of heroic rating experience because the demand, the pressure is that much greater. people are sometimes shitting their pants. I mean, that's not the environment that I want to produce either. I don't want apps that are shitting themselves on their raid days. You know, I want a pretty relaxed environment, but I don't want people to fuck around either, right? I don't want people wasting their time or my time or whatever. So it's very difficult to have that, you know, kind of mix. But it also depends on the person. Some people get really anxious, or, you know, they don't like being critiqued over vent. But it is one of the quickest ways to give feedback, right? Like, hey man, don't stand in that shit. That's it. That's all I said. I said, don't stand in that fire. I see you standing in fire. Well, I do my healing rotation. Don't stand in it. But people, you know, some people don't respond well to that. Hey there, SA. No, Austin. I'm teasing here. Relax. I mean, take sand out of your vagina. Noxic. Everybody's, well, most people, some people, did use Noxic initially. Why is Noxic a bad resource? Because information on it is inaccurate. It's wrong, and that's fine. If you use Noxic now, totally fine, but stop using it. There are better things out there. It's just like people. I mean, people give bad advice or good advice. People that are giving bad advice, you know, could be on Noxic, but you learn. You learn that there are better people that give advice elsewhere, and that's what you choose from. So don't worry about it. It's no, you're not a bad player. Everybody starts somewhere. I used to be a window licking, keyboard turning friggin' jackalope too, and a clicker, right? I used to click spells too. Actually, I don't think I did that, but I was a keyboard turner before. And you try new things, and you adapt, and, you know, you give things a chance to see if you can improve. And that's how you get better, right? That's how you get better. I'm trying to be nice, Blue. I mean, I understand that people have used Noxic, and that's all they knew. Well, why? Because there's not a lot of people saying, you know, use this. They go to Trade Chat. Guys, they go to Trade Chat, and, you know, they ask, what's a great resource site? And people will say, go to Noxic. Because most people don't know that Nox doesn't have the right information, so they don't know better. It's that kind of ignorance that we want to get rid of. You know, I want that Austin guy to become a better player. I want him to improve. I want to turn him from whatever his progression is now to potentially a heroic raider. But it does take time. And we like to joke around here and be sarcastic, Austin, so take no offense. We just really don't like Noxic. I don't like people giving the wrong information out. As pretty as that website looks, and as much money as they make off that website, I don't agree with it. Sorry, I got recruitment messages here. Noxic's workout does the Broncos. Is Peyton Manning on the Broncos? I don't know. And that dude, his name, that guy that's been on the news all the time, he's on the next one. Use howtopriest.com. Well, there's not a lot of resources for other classes, but there's Vikna's guide. There's a lot of great resources out there. It's wrong to say, you know, I don't have a resource. There's tons of resources out there. Yeah, I mean, number one is talking to people. You talk to people that know their shit. You can't just say, hey, random jackalope of guild XYZ, because I'm Canadian, you know, how do you do this? You know, it's one thing to talk to people of your own guild, but you have to know that they know what they're talking about. You know, how do you know Sparty is not pulling shit out of his ass? Right, well, I have some kind of evidence to back me up. You know, I have numbers, I have logs, I have, you know, a rating history. I've got that stuff to back me up and my claims and what I say is better or worse or did not work for me or might work for you. And I have no reason to lie to you guys, right? Like, I want you guys to improve. That's the whole purpose of this stream. Awesome, guys. That was a good one. We can do another LFR here or something. Or I'll fly around or... I don't know. Anyway, good job, guys. Good job. I'll do another LFR. But recruitment. Back to recruitment. So, recruitment. Let me load this up again here. So number two for recruitment is when you're on the guild recruitment forums. Let me pull these up for you guys again. Give me one sec, guys, and I'll start up another raid. Pull. There. So here are the guild recruitment forums. Let's say I am looking for a certain class. You know, I'm looking for a certain resto druid because Zundir life grips me too many times. Well, here is a 577 resto druid looking for a guild. Let's look at him. Okay, so here's information about him. Here's his armory. Let's take a look at his armory. This is how I would be a recruitment officer. He's got pretty good gear, you know, pretty well geared for a resto druid. What is he? He was said he was like 11 out of 14 or something. Yeah, 11 out of 14. He's a godly resto druid, missing a couple of glyphs here. Okay, so his armory checks out. I don't know a ton about resto druids. I'm pretty sure they should be running the 13,000 haste cap. He's at it, which is perfect. What days can he raid? Well, he's been around since BC, looking for a competent guild. From Twilight Gooses, here's his healing ranks, where healing ranks don't mean a ton. But here's the days he can raid. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I raid Monday to Thursday from 9:30 to 12:30. Is this going to work for me? Maybe. This might work. But would he have to leave early, or can he stay... You know, or can he... I don't know. Can he stay another half an hour? Well, you know what? I'm going to leave my post for him. Here's his battle tag. Because I don't have all the time in the world, we're all busy bees here, I have a recruitment post, a little template that I'm going to spam on his thing here. I haven't updated this one. What the fuck? How have I not updated this one? Oh, I did. Okay, I'm going to spam our little link here. Or not spam it. I'm just going to hit him with our little blurb about Death Jesters. I'm going to post it here. There. So greetings, you know, from Death Jesters, current progression, which is what they want to know, raid times, more about the guild. We're one of the oldest raiding guilds out there. Pride ourselves of being a closely bonded guild. Any questions, etc., etc., etc. Quick. It's not as long as my huge... wall of spam here, so they're not forced to, like, I'm just going to skip this because it's too much reading and I'm super lazy. So that is one thing you do. You go on the crewman forums and you hunt. You hunt for those people. A protection paladin to replace Tauli. That's a great one. Oh, okay. Well, I see. Oh, Glyph already posted on him. Glyph's a good guy. Looking for guild raid 2 or 4 nights a week. Stable post rating. I guess I could post on this guy too. Sure, why not? I guess we gotta wait a couple seconds. I have an add-on. I guess that add-on doesn't work anymore. Anyway, I have an add-on that shows what characters they're hiding between or behind. Let me see if I can show it really quick here. Where's my add-ons? Seer, did you kill this add-on? Tools, add-ons. Yeah, it should be working. Wow, Forum Bastard mode. It's updated recently. Turn it on. Yeah, it should be working. I don't know why it's not. I guess it's not working. Anyway, so you take the effort to post on all of these webs, on all these forums, on your own ones or on your server. So here's my server ones. I have a nice little link right here. There's a Frost Mage looking for a guild. Mages just aren't ideal for heroics. I'm sort of going to skip them for now. Yeah, he can only raid Saturday, Sunday. He uses Icy Vein. That's, you know, a good start there. What else? Opponent. Brewmaster. Oh, Tauli replacement here too. He's just transferred. Here's his armory link. Whatever. So, basically you type in your little chat here. Feel free to use mine or feel free to steal mine. My little blurbs there. If you ever want to link to them, I'll totally show you guys. Guys, I'm not replacing Tauli. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. I'm totally kidding here. So that is that. One second, let me turn my mic here. Might be a little bit easier there, so you guys can hear me better when I turn my head. There. I'm sure Tali's heard about it already. I can't see anything without people taking it seriously. And here's the post that I bumped earlier. Oh no, that's a different one. So basically you put in the work, but this kind of process is super, super, super time consuming. This is a bitch to be going through page by page looking for a warlock. Warlock is something I'm always looking for. Here's the post that I bumped earlier. Recruiting a warlock. I guess I could type, you know, control F and look for a warlock. So that would work. Another great resource. Well, that is sort of outdated, but still sort of works, is wowlemmings.com. This one. This used to be a really great resource a while ago. Music's a bit loud. Let me turn it down. You're right, it is a little bit loud. There. It's perfect. Maybe I don't have to talk as loud if my music's not loud. So Wow Lemmings is a great website as well for recruiting for your guilds. What region? Let's say I'm looking for US because I'm in North America. Looking, I don't care about faction right now. Servers, don't leave it or leave it as is. Looking for a warlock. There's an idiot filter that doesn't work anymore. Sort of ignore it. There. Scan. Now, this sorts all warlocks looking for a guild based off the date of their posting. This warlock is looking for a 10 man. Well, 10 men's for Care Bears. I'm gonna skip this guy. Warlock looking for a good home? Maybe. You know, I'm a good home. Here's his link. So he might not be a raider. Probably not. So let's go back here. So this links directly to their Warcraft posts or their MMO champion posts. Let's look here. Click on this dude. Oh, this might be a package deal, though. So yes, there's a Holy Paladin and a 571 Warlock looking for a guild that raids no more than 4 times a week. Their raid times, which would sort of work for us, except I'm a Holy Paladin and I'm not really looking to replace... I guess I am looking to replace myself. So then you would post on MMO Champion. This is a great sort of filter and search function for that. WoW Progress is a recruitment tool as well. Let me put up WoW Progress. WoW Progress, you can start looking for people that are characters, realm, where is it again? Characters that are looking for a guild. There. People that are looking for a guild, let's say that raids, right now we raid 4 days a week, we speak English, go. So this tells you their item level. I mean, it's really bad right now because I sort of put on both EU and US, but you can make it to just one, I believe, just there. So I sort by character item level. I could sort by how many pets they have. Let's sort by pets. So these guys have a lot of pets. They might make good players. Ryken on Shadow Manifest has a lot of pets. Let's click on Ryken. He's got a crap ton of pets. Let's look at his armory. That's his guild. Where is his armory? Back to character profile. There. Where's his damn armory go? Shadow Manifest. No. Oh, there it is. Armory. So look at Ryken here. He's now pretty decently geared. 564 mage. Yeah, not bad. He's got some heroic experience as well. He's killed Garrosh heroic. He must have bought that kill. He must have a lot of money. Probably purchased a kill from LA. You know, so he does have that heroic Garrosh experience, despite him being on the floor, face down, ass up for a while. So WoW Progress is great for also looking for players, you know, as well as people looking for a guild. But there's a lot of great resources out there. I mean, word of mouth is great. You can use trade chat, general chat, whatever you want to look for those guilds. A wild warlock appears. Hey, Nerzuk. Oh god, did I set this 1025 stuff again? Oh god. Guys, I'm kidding. I'm kidding here. I know 10 men's are just as hardcore. I like to be sarcastic. I apologize if you don't read my sarcasm, but 10 men's are just as hardcore. Just as hardcore. Welcome, Lego Migogo. Lego Me. Lego My Ego. 2772. Welcome. Thanks for supporting us. Much appreciated. Thanks a ton. Okay. So, that is how you typically recruit for a guild. What are we looking at here? Good. Okay. Sparty, you might not remember that I asked for raid leading tips about 2 weeks ago. I remember you, Mark Daly. Of course I do. I was just starting a new team, but thanks to all your tips and watching your stream out, we are now on Garrosh and hoping for a kill tomorrow or Tuesday. Kill tomorrow. Kill it tomorrow so you can start heroics on Tuesday. And then go for it. Anyway. Good, okay. So, next thing is how to find a guild. That's one of the major questions you guys ask here. I'll show you guys. I can't really do stuff while I guess I can just fly around. Let's go to Eastern Plague Lands while I fly. Have you looked at bad apps yet? No, not yet, guys. I will look at apps. I will look at apps for sure. There. So that is WoW Progress in a nutshell. It's a really great resource for looking for a guild as well as recruiting for your guilds. Now, I'll go to WoW Progress. I need... Who is looking for a guild? I know a lot of you guys are looking for a guild. I'll try to pull up one or two of you. Give me somebody that is in a normal guild or a heroic guild. I'm looking for you guys specifically. Because this will really look at you guys a bit more. Should do Blackmoon Descent. I can't do two things at once here. I have to do off-website stuff or off-game stuff. You said 10 minutes? Shit, has it been more than 10 minutes? Okay, let me do this one thing, Tramp, and I will do your question right after. What realm am I on? I'm on Stormrage US right now. Logos. Just link me an armory, guys. Link me armory. Link me armories here. I have volunteer shuttle. Of course we can volunteer shuttle. Let's look at seven pandas on Doomed Knight. Plenty. Okay, dude, that's a great one. Okay, Doomed Knight, thanks a lot. So let's pull up his armory. Doomed Knight, thanks for volunteering. So let's look at his armor really quick here. You know, I don't know a crap ton about Death Knights. I know Frost is the better DPS spec in terms of gearing, gemming. I don't know. I'm pretty sure the Evil Eye is the best trinket for Death Knights, as well as Thok's Tail Tip. Always the tip is better. Always start with the tip. So Frost, DK, great. Let's look at his progression. He's got professions good. Everything checks out in terms of enchanting, gemming. That's all done. Gear has been fairly upgraded. Let's see what he upgraded. He's upgraded his weapon, his trinkets. Good, 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 good. Awesome. Quick little side here. Whenever you guys are upgrading gear, 99% of the time, it is always best to upgrade weapons first. Almost always better to upgrade weapons first, followed by trinkets. Those are generally the best ones. Of course, if you're a legendary cloak, upgrade that too. But weapon, generally, one of the best things to always upgrade. Now, let's look at his progression. His progression, he's killed all normal bosses here. He's got two kills in Siege of Orgrimmar Heroic. Perfect. Now, let's say he's looking for a new guild. You know, for whatever reason, let's say Uncommon Sense, the guild leader, the raid leader, everybody but Doomed Knight gets hit by a bus tomorrow. A big bus driven by one of our warlocks. The irony in that. So he's looking for a guild now. What is he going to do? Well, why don't you tell me how many days a week you want to raid? Whether you're looking to do Alliance, US, whatever. Let's pull this up here. There. So he is on, number one, he's on the EU US servers. So let's look for a US guild. Let's go back to the main page here. This is how you look for a guild. WoW Progress is awesome for this. So let's look at US guilds only. And we'll see if... Yeah, I know it's already upgraded. I know. What else? Let's see his answer here. Logos. Please look at my new old paladin shuttle. Oh, fuck, okay. I'll put it in bookmarks here. Oh, God. Shuttle 2. He needs more gear. My suggestion for you, Shuttle 2, is Timeless Isle. Stat. Get right on that. Get on Timeless Isle. Okay, I'm gonna assume some stuff here. So he's looking for a guild, Doom Knight. He's looking for a guild probably around, I don't know, a heroic raiding guild. But let's look. Let's say he wants to stay Alliance, because he's Alliance, right? Yes, he's Alliance. He's Alliance, good guy. He's looking to raid, let's say, 3 days a week. He doesn't care about 10 or 25, man, so I'm gonna leave it right here on tier 16. He wants an English-speaking guild that is looking for a Death Knight that is a damage dealer. Damage dealer, DD, or direct damage. Click go. There. These are all guilds, 25-man guilds, 10-man guilds, that are Alliance, raid 3 days a week, speak English, looking for a Death Knight that is a direct damage Death Knight, so a DPS one. This sorts by progression. Now let's look at his progression for a sec here. His progression was 2 out of 14. He's only got one kill at each of those bosses. So I'm always look higher, always look better than you. Most people leave guilds, you know, because their guilds are falling apart or whatever. But he's going to look for a guild, let's say, that's at least 4... There must have been something really hilarious. That's okay.
Can you mute your microphone for just one sec?
Okay. Is this like Project Runway?
I just like can't say it.
That was disgusting. She's watching Project Runway, and somebody has super tight booty shorts where they're so tight that this person's package is just coming out of the booty. Their lady. Let's keep this PG-13, relatively PG-13. Oh god, that's a one image. Let's go back to recruitment. So this is 25 and 10 man guilds that are looking for a death knight. Now we're going to look for a guild that is ideally 4 out of 14 or more. Let's look for 25 man guilds because I like 25 man guilds more. Let's look for underpaid and overplay. I don't really like that name because they spelled and wrong with an N, as you can see. Here, late crew. Let's look at late crew. Click on them. Okay. They're a 25 man guild, as you can tell here. They're realm 4th. They're on Cenarius. They're recruiting all classes. That's not really specific. They're not looking just for Death Knights, but they also don't have a lot of information about them. They have their website, and then that's it. That's why I said it's really important to have your own little WoW progress blurb here. Let's look for a different guild. Let's look for this guild, Malice. 9 out of 14 on Sargeras. Okay, here we go. So let's say he wants to jump from 2 out of 14 to 9 out of 14. Totally doable. You can definitely do that. They have a medium need for Death Knights. That's not bad. They raid 3 days a week. They're casual 25 men. Here's a lot of information about them. Last tier, they got 9 out of 13. This tier, they're 9 out of 14, which is already better than last year. They've done 6 out of 7 Firelands. They've, you know, done most bosses. They've been on Sargeras since Burning Crusades. Have been around for a long time. That's great. One of the best things, one of the most important things you guys look for in a guild is longevity. Longevity. Yes, that's the word. A guild that has been around for a long, 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 long time, like Death Jesters, there is very little chance that it will ever fall apart. That's what you definitely want. So looking for DPS for the 25-man roster, exceptional reliable players, whatever. This is the kind of loot system they want to use. EPGP, use whatever you want here. I don't like point systems. I use a loot council. Here's information on how to apply. So this is a pretty decent blurb about them. If I was looking to raid, I mean, does this say raid times? Yes, it does. So they raid Tuesday, Wednesday, and Monday. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Monday. 6:45 till 10 server time. Let's say Doom Knight, he's a Canadian. And what do Canadians do on Monday nights? Oaf, they play hockey. He can only raid Tuesday and Wednesday. So maybe this isn't the guild for Doom Knight over here. Yeah, he wants to do high-end heroic stuff, but he has hockey because he's a friggin' maple syrup drinking Canuck. He's gonna look for a different guild then. Let's look for, you know, move on and on and on until you find the right guild for you. There's a lot of things to consider when you are looking for a guild, you know, raid times, loot system, type of guild it is, whether you're going to fit in with them, 25 men, 10 men. I mean, some people, they don't have a computer that runs 10 men's. Stop making fun of me here. Monday, shut up. Stupid stream delay. I said Monday. Digital guilds aren't everything. They're not. They're only one thing. There are many things. Many, many things. Stable guilds do help, though. They're a huge, huge, huge thing. So this is WoW progress again, how to find a guild. Let me go through one more here. Let's find somebody on EU. Do you have any EU peoples? EU peoples that are looking for a guild? Can I pull you guys up for one more example, please? Just link me your armory. I don't care who you are. Sub, non-sub. And I'll switch over. I think I'll do some US Horde LFRs tonight as well while we do Coach's Corner. You can always link your armory, Morhig. Link away. Let's see. I want an EU one, though. I hate Mondays, too. Everybody hates Mondays. Jerks. Making fun of me. Stop with the Mondays crap. Okay, here's an EU person. Arvo. Arvo, you're on EU. Perfect, thank you. Aw, this doesn't help. You're a heroic garage-killing bastard. Okay, Arvo, I'm going to use you anyway, since you're from Aurora. But also not what I was looking for. I guess you might be looking for a guild. If only, I swear to God, if only you were on Stormrage US, not friggin' European. That would have been much better. Okay, so let's pull up, I'm going to throw up some imaginary information from Arvu. Let's say he's a balanced druid, okay? He's a balanced druid that is looking for a guild on EU. I'm going to say his progression is only 10 out of 14. Okay, let's say he's 10 out of 14 because he's down spoils, but he can't do Thakket because his guild sort of fell apart. So, let's look for EU guilds only. So we're going to go to WoW Progress again, click it, reset all the settings. Go to EU only. This now sorts EU guilds only. He wants to be a 25-man raider. He's been 10-man raider all his life, but he's heard great things about 25-mans, and he wants to do 25-mans only. So I'm going to click right here. Now we have only 25-mans in our search. He is a... There we go. A dirty, scumbag, rock-eating horde. He wants to stay horde as well. He doesn't care about those, you know, shitty little lines with their crappy DPS racials. And he wants to raid, let's say, 3 days a week. That's usually the norm. He was English-speaking, looking for a druid that is balanced. There. A balanced druid. Go. There we go. So these are horde guilds looking for a balanced druid sorted by their progression. Right here. Let's say, you know, he's 10 out of 14 now. So he's going to look at this page for guilds that are recruiting. Let's say Realities Function. I like this guild name. Has information about them. They're 25 men at raiding 3 days a week. Here are the times they raid. They have a high need or low need for a balanced druid. So maybe this isn't the right guild for him. He might apply anyway, but maybe not. Let's look at Bovine. I like this guild name. Bovine Intervention. Here's a lot of information about them. Great. When they raid, what do we expect from them? Attitude. There's a video of them wiping 25 men's. I don't want to show it on stream in case it's something bad. And their progression. There's the website. They have a, I guess, low need as well. Let's say it was high. I would apply to this guild. The more applications you send out, it's sort of like applying to a job. I know it's a game, but the more you apply to guilds, the more chances you have of finding a guild. Some guilds like that you only apply to one guild at a time, but you're in it for you. Yes, you want to be part of a guild. Let's say you want to be part of Bovine Intervention, and they're your dream. You love that cow guild. And you have this thing for cows. You love this guild name. You want to down Heroic Garrosh. I'm sure they're pretty close to downing Heroic Garrosh. I have no freaking clue. But he would, you know, potentially apply to this guild. If he doesn't like them, you know, he doesn't like their loot system, what days they raid, look for a new one. Mist on Draenor. Again, same thing. Oh, here they have a high need for balanced druids. There. Same thing they're looking for. It's got a lot of great information here. Who to contact. You know, before even applying, he would type in, you know, add them to Real ID, this person. Monzita, contact one of our officers. So I would go to my little Real ID thing here. Yeah, you guys. Go to friends, add a new friend. There, Monzita. Hi, I'm a 10 out of 14. Boomkin, looking to apply. Saw your information on progress. There, send request. Oh, well. Whatever. Doesn't matter. So, that's how you would apply to a guild, or sort of get information on how to find a guild. How to figure out Warcraft logs? I'm going to show you, Sean, some. Give me a while to do it. Give me a while here. Soki had a question as well. Soki, looking for a Friday or Saturday night guild on my current realm. Okay, now here's one more. Here's a great one. Thanks, Soki, here. One sec. Okay, Soki. Oh, you're a pretty awesome warrior. You're a 564. Okay, this will be the last one that I show here before I move on, guys. I didn't think that request would actually work, because it was an EU realm. So I wonder if I get a response from that person. What are you inviting me for? Oh, best friends. Anyway. So if somebody contacts me about a boomkin, I'll pretend, I don't know. My name is Avalanche. Or this guy, My name is, I'm his main character. So, Soki, you're looking for a guild that raids 2 days a week on Fridays and Saturdays. Let's see your current progression. You've got professions down, you've got your stuff down here, let's go to advanced armory. Your shit's enchanted, it's upgraded, great, great, great. Your progress is probably killing normals. Yeah, you've killed all normals multiple times, awesome. So what you want to look for is a heroic raiding guild, potentially. I'm sort of guessing here. This will be the last one that I show, before I move on to the next thing here. One of the reasons Spud is so lovable. Let's look for... What was he looking for, Soki? Yeah, set up the guild there, Shansom, and I'll sort of show you how to analyze logs. But yeah, and Creeper, I'll answer your question as well. As well as the guy that I told him about the 15 men in his guild. I mean, that was a great question. What is the website I'm on? WowProgress.com, Pedenko. Okay. So Soki, let me see his thing here. Where was Soki's question? Friday said on his current realm, so he's on Sargeras. Okay, and now we want to look for people or guilds only on Sargeras. Let's go to US here. We'll just go realms. Let's go to realms here. Let's go to Sargeras, which is, you know, one of the best realms out there. They're one of the best alliance realms for PvP. Again, there's not much PvP going on there anyway, so it's not a huge deal. They do have Midwinter, of course, and they have Vanquish. So he's looking for a 10-man guild on this server, right? 10 men. Well, he doesn't say 10 men. Friday or Saturday. That's a lot harder to find, but we'll find you, hopefully, a guild here. So let's look for either 25 or 10 men on this server only, since I've got Sargeras realm ranking pulled up here. Any faction is fine. Let's say Alliance, because there's no Hordes on here. You want to raid 1 to 2 days a week. And guilds that usually raid 1 to 2 days a week will usually be on the weekend. They're English-speaking, and they're looking for a... You were a DPS warrior, I'm pretty sure. You're right, Soki? Yeah, you're a DPS warrior. Looking for a warrior that is DPS. Go. Done. These are all the guilds that are looking for a warrior. Now, your progression, right, was 14 out of 14 normals. Let's look for a heroic raiding guild then. Vix Dalo. Never heard of this guild. They're 4 out of 14. That would be a pretty good jump for you. Going for more heroic bosses, that would be pretty good because you get to experience some of the content that they've already done, plus potentially work on the progression. With them as well. You know, some people hate applying to guilds that are 14 out of 14 because they don't experience the progression as well. And it's a lot harder to evaluate apps under pressure when it's everything's on farm content in fucking Dragon Soul. Okay, so let's look at Vel Dalo here. Okay. They're semi-hardcore. It doesn't tell me when they raid. That sucks. Too bad for these guys. I might advertise their guild to Soki here. Let's look at Icon, 8 out of 14. It's quite a big jump, but still doable. Oh, here we go. So here, they raid Fridays and Saturdays, occasionally on Sunday. This might be a good choice for you, Soki. They raid 6 to 10 Pacific, so 9 to 1 Eastern. There you go, 9 to 1 Eastern. They're looking for additional players. They have a high need for a DPS warrior. Okay, what they're looking for, types of players that are prepared, know their shit. This might be a really good, really good game for you. You know, I don't know much about him, even though it says 10 men here or 25. It doesn't matter. I mean, they might be looking for more players either way. But it's 25 men, so yeah. Vox Dolls, 8 out of 14. Yeah, that would be a pretty good guild for you to apply to. Vox Dalo. Yeah, for sure. It is a big jump, but I've seen people go from, you know, 8 out of 14 normal to 6 out of 14 heroic on this stream alone. Yeah. So that might be a great one. I mean, we sort of lucked out here because it's a Friday-Saturday guild. They're heroic raiding. I mean, it'll be a lot more competitive. It'll be a lot more pressure. But you have the entire week to prepare, right? And you'd have to really sell yourself as to why you're ready for this Vox Dalo guild, or Dalo, or whatever you call them. You know, why they should take you with zero heroic experience. What have you done for heroics before? That doesn't count. that also doesn't count. Well, that might count. I would say these ones count. But when I look at kills like Dragon Soul Heroic, Mogoshan Vaults, that kind of stuff, if it's only ever been one kill, I don't think they've been a heroic raider. But you've probably killed a couple heroics, Jinrock and Horrodon, I think. So you've got some heroic raiding experience, but sell them. Sell them on yourself. Why are you the best damn Fury Warrior for this guild? Sell them on it, Soki. And that's how you do it. So, that, I mean, we sort of lucked out there because you found a perfect guild. Last question for recruitment for now. Any suggestion on two people applying together, husband and wife sort of thing? We've gotten a bunch of them before. A bunch of, you know, dual apps. Dual apps are good and bad. Usually bad. Guilds try to shy away from them. Or package deals. Package deals. And I'll tell you a story why. We had a couple sort of packages apply before. We had a husband and wife back in Sunwell. A resto shaman, godly, and a holy priest, that was Varelis and Eolant. They stuck around for the entire expansion. They stuck around for a while. I met them in person. They were really nice people. They just moved on because, I mean, it was just getting too much of a hardcore environment for them. But they were a package deal. Well, not really a package deal, but two people that applied together, and that did work out. The reason most guilds don't accept package deals is this. One player can be awesome. Let's say your wife is awesome and you're sort of crappy because, you know, you in your spare time like to do nothing but PvP and pet battles and just farm stuff. You don't have a lot of raiding experience. You don't have that drive, that competitive nature that your wife does. I know it sounds, you know, a little off. So guilds don't want one player that is awesome and the other player is sort of just being carried or propped up by this awesome player. Because then they're forced to bring along this sort of crappy player. I'm not saying, you know, your husband or wife are crappy, but does create issues. Back in Molten Core, we had a boyfriend and girlfriend apply as a package deal. It was a mage by the name of Eva Kami and a priest by the name of Rebecca. We had them both in their applicant phase. So let's see, look at my roster here. We have applicants here. Applicants, then trials, then full members. And then veterans officers. So they were in their applicant phase right here. And we promoted, you know, they were doing pretty decently, you know, above average, I would say. We're like, you know what, I think the priest is ready for her next trial phase. Let's move her on to the next section. So we chatted with her, you know, she was good with it. But we said, you know, why don't we wait on the mage for another couple days, maybe a week at most, because he's still got a little bit more work to do, and we'll go from there. I mean, we didn't talk to the mage, because we usually talk to apps as we update them through their app process. But we promoted her, not him, and he got really jealous, you know, and it's not all couples are like this, but he got super, super jealous, and he deleted all her gear, her Eye of Divinity. I'm pretty sure he deleted her character as well, maybe, can't remember, but he went that far. Like, he was super jealous of her being promoted first. He thought he wouldn't get into the guild. Well, she doesn't deserve to get into a guild either. I don't know what happened with this relationship. It doesn't sound like a really healthy relationship, but that's one of the reasons, you know, most guilds don't take package deals. That being said, the best package deal we've ever had, six or so players from one guild that sort of fell apart. It was a GM, raid leader, couple of their full-time members. They applied during Sunwell Muru progression, one of the hardest parts of, the hardest points of raiding was Muru progression. And they applied, not as a package deal, but all to the same guild, and they thought, or they knew, that they were all individually great players and they would get in on their own merits. That's totally okay. So if you, let's say you and your wife apply to my guild, totally fine, you know, if we're looking for your classes, as long as you all applied individually on your own merits and you knew that you would be good enough to get in on your own, that would be totally fine, you know, and we're okay with that. Like, I don't care about boyfriends, girlfriends, you know, husband, wives playing together. So that's totally fine. So those players, those 5-6 players that came together, all applied on their own to the same guild. Their guild leader became one of my officers and best raid leaders ever at my Elemental Shaman during Ice Crown and Resto Shaman during Sunwell. Karnik still plays to this day. You guys know him as the Iron Star kiting minion of Yashar, kiting guy on Heroic Garage. He's played as Hunter initially, switched over to his Mistweaver for us. He's one of the most loyal and dedicated players ever. He's also a super, super nice guy in real life. Awesome guy. We had Sticky Buns, which still sort of plays sometimes. I don't know where he is. We had Lumerax, which plays on our 10-man team. So those guys are still around. So that was one of the best sort of decisions that we made, just accepting this group app, giving them a chance. So, that's why, that's the answer as to why yes and no group apps are okay or not bad or whatever.